नमस्कार सर, प्रथम आप सब लोगों को मतलब की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं। जैसा कि आप सबको विदित है कि आज हमारे फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर साहब ने पार्लियामेंट में कम्बाइंड बजट पेश किया, जिसमें जनरल और रेलवे बजट दोनों का समन्वय था। जो रेलवे बजट है ये 1924 में अलग से प्रस्तुत किए जाने की प्रथा अपवर्ड कमेटी के रिकमेंडेशन के फलस्वरूप शुरू करी गई थी, और आज 92 वर्षों के पश्चात एक हिस्टोरिक स्टेप लिया गया है और ये जनरल बजट के साथ में इसको वापस से मर्ज किया गया है। हमारे वित्त मंत्री जी ने जो बजट के दौरान बताया कि ऑल्दो दी बजट इज बीइंग रेलवे बजट इज बीइंग मर्ज विद दी फाइनेंस जनरल बजट, रेलवे विल रिटेन इट्स फंक्शनल ऑटोनॉमी एंड वेन एवर नीडेड एमआर कैन प्रेजेंट टू दी पार्लियामेंट व्हाइट पेपर और विजन प्लान एक्सेट्रा टू कम्युनिकेट इशूज अबाउट एक्शन प्लान फॉर द रेलवे। All the legislative work of budget process will be done by the finance minister. The purpose of merging the two budgets is probably to facilitate multimodal transport planning and development, that is combined planning and development for railways, highways, waterways as well as the airways. Finance minister, while presenting the budget and talking about the railways, he focused on following areas for the railways. Number one, passenger safety. On this side, he has announced creation of a railway, Rashtriya Rail Suraksha Kosh, RRSK, to the tune of 1 lakh crore, which will be created over a period of 5 years. All unmanned LCs will be eliminated from broad gauge routes by 2020. Next thrust area is about capital and developmental works. Expenditure has been pegged at the level of ₹1,31,000 crores, almost one third of the total budget for the next financial year for the railways. In this, a very tall target of adding 3,500 kilometers of new track has been fixed, against about 28 kilometers which were added during 2016-17. The throughput enhancement has been targeted for increase by over 10% in next 3 years. The next focus area which he has put in the budget is cleanliness, and in this all the bio toilets of all coaches, they will be replaced, all the toilets in the coaches, railway coaches, they will be replaced with bio toilets by 2019. Certain financial and accounting reforms have also been targeted, in which accrual based financial statement will be prepared by March 2019, and he has also indicated that shares for railway PSCs like IRCTC, IRFC, Vodafone, etc., they will be listed. Station redevelopment is also a thrust area, and two of the stations, Habibganj on West Central Railway and Gandhinagar on Western Railway, the contracts for these two stations have already been finalized for redevelopment, and 24 stations more are targeted for the current year, in which Southeastern Railway's Ranchi station is included. He has also indicated that dedicated trains and corridors for tourism and pilgrimage purposes will be developed. Friends, because of certain constraints or because of certain restrictions on account of announcement of the elections on 5 of the states, much details about project-wise works included in the budget are yet not available. Hopefully they will be available during next few days, and then we will be able to share you more details, specific details about the projects which are falling on South Eastern Railway. However, some picture has been made available about the outlay for projects on various states. As far as South Eastern Railway is concerned, our coverage is on three states, and for those three states, the total outlay projected, I'll just indicate you the figures, and they are not limited to South Eastern Railway. They are limited to all the railways covering on those particular states. As far as state of West Bengal is concerned, the outlay during 2016-17 was 3,820 crores, which has been enhanced to 6,336 crores. That is almost 65%. 6,336 crores, which is almost 65% more than last year. I think this is the maximum enhancement which has been given to any of the states. The next is Odisha, where the last year it was 4,682 crores, and the next year it is projected as 5,102. That is 5,102 crores. There is an increase of almost 9%. As far as the state of Jharkhand is concerned, the allotment during 2016-17 was 2,235 crores, which has been increased to 2,583 crores. That is almost 16% increase that has been indicated in the budget papers. Friends, rest all details are not yet available to us, so I cannot give you specific project-wise or other details, but at the same time, I like to share on this occasion some of the highlights of South Eastern Railway with all of you. Just to mention that South Eastern Railway is a proud railway which carries about 12% of the Indian Railways loading, and that too over meager 4% of the track network length. Our loading target for the current year is 141 million ton, and up to 20th of January we have already done 117.53 million ton, which is 11.86% more than last year, and also about 4% more than the proportional target set for us. Passenger carried during the year up to 20th January is 208 million as compared to last year's figure of 206.37 million, that is about 0.8% more. As far as total earnings are concerned, our earnings has been 1,10,019 crores as compared to 1,193 crores last year. That is, there is a growth of about 8.10% over last year. However, we are still, because the expected growth was 10%, so we are lagging by about 1.9% as per the target. However, it is more by 8.1%. Our operating ratio is around 82.7% in spite of absorbing the effect of 7th pay commission. And just to make a mention, the present the overall figure for Indian Railways is around 109%. I hope all of you must be familiar with this term operating ratio. It indicates that for earning 1 rupee, how much we are spending. So if I am saying my operating ratio is 82.7%, that means to earn 1 rupee, I am spending 82.7 paisa. So that is a direct indication of the efficiency of a system, railway system. We run about 544 passenger carrying trains, including mail express, passengers and suburban trains, and on an average about 450 goods trains daily. Our punctuality during the current year has been 97.55% as compared to 95.81% last year. As far as infrastructure building is concerned, we had completed 5 of the projects, adding about 62 kilometers of track to our system. And another section is shortly going to be opened, that is Barki Champi Tori, about 30 kilometers. So that will make around 92 kilometers of new track, and some sidings also will also be opened by the end of the year, which will add another 35 kilometers of track. Recently, Honorable MR has flagged off this Howrah-Yashwantpur Hamsafar Express train on 20th of January, and he remotely flagged off that train from Howrah. I hope some of you might have covered that event also and seen those coaches. Then frequency of 12074 Bhumeshwar Howrah Jan Shatabdi has been increased from 6 days to daily with effect from 3rd of July 2016. Similarly, Puri Howrah Shatabdi Express, that was also made daily from the same date. As far as cleanliness is concerned, we have covered all major stations with mechanized cleaning contracts, and other places, other smaller stations, we are managing with our departmental resources or through cash impress. CCTVs have been installed for monitoring the cleanliness as well as the security aspects at the stations, at 11 stations. 459 coaches have been converted into bio toilets, and another around 25 to 30 coaches will be added, will be converted into bio toilets by end of this year. Similarly, for providing better cleanliness on the trains, onboard housekeeping services are in place in 51 trains, which are maintained by us, and another 18 pairs will be covered by March 2017. Towards green initiative, solar panels have been commissioned at 6 of the stations and 212 level crossings. As far as passenger amenities are concerned, high speed Wi-Fi service at Ranchi and Tata Nagar has been started. 17 important stations of South Eastern Railway have been covered under Janani Seva scheme, in which we provide on payment facilities like baby food, hot water, etc., and some small cubicle so that mothers can feed the babies or change the wrapper, etc. Divyang friendly toilets have been provided at 15 stations of A1, A and B category. 3 escalators are operational at Kharagpur, Ranchi and Hatia stations, and further is being extended to Bokaro Steel Plant, Rourkela and Tata Nagar, Jharsuguda in this financial year. Similarly, 4 number of lifts have been provided at Kharagpur station, and 12 more lifts will be installed at Bokaro, Rourkela, Tata Nagar, Hatia, Ranchi, Kharagpur and Barasur stations shortly. 79 trains are covered under e-catering, where 35 meals are ordered per month on an average. At present, we have 770 PRS locations, 76 UTS, cum PRS locations, and 174 UTS, that is unreserved ticketing system locations over Southeastern Railway. And to accomplish the mission cashless transaction, we started from 8th of December provision of POS machine at the UTS cum PRS locations, and 259 such POS machines have been installed so far, and another about 150 machines will be added by end of this financial year. Our target is to go for about 500 machines. The machines are being provided to us by the State Bank of India, and as and when they are making available these machines, we are providing them at our locations. With this, there has been a growth of 5.41% in PRS earning up to January 2017. In addition, we have also, to facilitate buying of the tickets, we have also installed coin operated ticket vending machines at 10 locations, Yatri ticket Suvidha came at 7 locations, Jan Sadharan ticket booking sevak at 8 locations and station ticket booking agent at 64 locations. Paperless mobile application ticketing facility is available on Southeastern Railway at all the stations between Howrah and Midnapur, Panspura and Haldia, Santragachi and Amta, and Santragachi and Shalimar. To clear extra rush during festivals and other seasons, we have been regularly running special trains, and 342 special trains, 61 premium Suvidha trains were run during this period. We also augmented coaches in the existing trains, and 2986 extra coaches were attached on temporary basis to different trains where the waiting lists were high. In addition, 7 coaches have been added to certain trains on permanent basis. We have also taken work of increasing length of platform and raising the height of platforms, as well as improving the platform surface. In addition, for the comfort of the passengers, 119 platform shelters have been provided at 22 stations this year, and another 40 more bays at 13 stations will be provided by March 2017. 3 numbers footover bridges have been constructed at Shalimar, Sirjam and Purulia this year, and 3 more stations, Ramsagar and Midnapur, they will be added completed by this year. Similarly, circulating areas at 5 stations have been improved. Washable aprons have been provided to improve the cleanliness at these stations, Diga and Shalimar. And apart from this, 86 stations on Southeastern Railway, they have been identified for development as other station, out of which 82 have already been completed, and 3 more stations, that is Chakulia, Gola Road and Basta, will be completed during this financial year. And the Shalimar station, where large scale work is going on, that will take about 2 years time. As far as safety is concerned, I am happy to inform you that so far our track record has been satisfactory and better as compared to last year, and we had 2 accidents as compared to 3 numbers last year. Out of these 2 also, one was on an unmanned level crossing where the motor vehicle, engine of the motor vehicle, it failed after the vehicle came on the train, on the level crossing, and resulted into a collision. Otherwise, the things are satisfactory. As far as elimination of unmanned LCs are concerned, we have a target of eliminating 185 unmanned LCs during the current year, and we have already completed work at 136 stations, and we will be completing this work of 185 level crossings, unmanned LCs, by 31st of March. And the remaining will be completed within next 2 years, as already indicated in the budget target also. As far as security of the passenger is concerned, we are equally concerned about security of the passengers, and 12 stations, major stations on Southeastern Railway, they are covered with CCTV camera, where more than 380 CCTV cameras are installed and being monitored by our control, RPF control. This is being round the clock, and this will be further extended for 10 more stations. Dog squads are also available and are being regularly deployed for the security purposes, as most of our sections are naxal infested, so those cares are also being taken with the help of these dog squads. Apart from that, regular escorting of the ladies compartments in the suburban trains, and night escorting of other trains is also being done with the help of GRP and RPF. our security personnel have received 247 complaints, and they have recovered 25 cases. They have recovered the material also, and around the clock security helpline by number 182 is available for the help of the passengers. With this, I once again thank you all for the patient hearing and taking the trouble for running from Eastern Railway headquarters to this place, and thank you very much.